And we are here in Las Vegas at the Money Team Gym. And we are here with Jay Leon Hill. So can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'm from Detroit, Michigan. Jay Leon Love. I'm 21 and 1 as a professional. Just chasing the dream like everybody else. So,
you had a fight on the undercard of a Mayweather fight.
Yeah.
You came to that fight So, what happened?
I really wasn't as disciplined as I am now. You know what I mean? I kind of took an opportunity. I trained, and I didn't train as hard as I do today. You know what I'm saying? And I'm like, I'm doing these fights. And what I love to make weight as a professional boxer, it's your job to be in the best condition possible. It's your job to train as hard as possible. Be on weight. There's a certain weight you're supposed to make. I actually had a lot going on. I actually had the death of my brother. You know, but I don't like to make excuses. So I was going through a lot. I was in and out of training. And you know, I finally tried to do everything last minute. You can't do anything last minute. You can't properly prepare yourself for a fight last minute.
So, how does your mentality change from that mistake? And how did you focus from that mistake?
You know what, man? You learn. A lot of people make mistakes. A lot of people don't learn from it. I learn from it. Boxing is a lifestyle. It's 24 hours a day. You know what I'm saying? You must eat, sleep, and groom yourself around boxing. You know, what you eat is how you get a show in your performance. You know what I'm saying? So everything I do is about boxing. And when you start making things more important than boxing, then you don't have love for the sport. So that's what I did. I started making things. I started putting distractions and things that wasn't important behind boxing. And now, I feel like every fight is most memorable. I won the WBA international title. I'm from Detroit, and I come from a historical gym called Crunk Boxing Gym. And it just so happened we were down in the gym training, and I have a spontaneous, I got a personality. I don't mind interacting with people. So we had this camera, I didn't know who we were for. For me, I was just messing with them, you know what I'm saying? Playing with them. And the lady came down, her name was Kate Morris. You know what I'm saying? I know now who she is, but then I didn't. And I was messing with her for it. We were playing about me and myself. You know, and they liked it. They were like, yo, we like your personality. We like your look. From there, it was real. I modeled with her several times in different magazines, and I ran with it. But I actually didn't know where it could have took me. I was like, modeling, that's what I was like, I didn't really take it seriously. As I got older, you know what, man, it's about sacrificing. The things that you really want, the things that you really, you know what I'm saying, that we all want the nice house, the nice cars, and the nice clothes, the things that we see. You know what I'm saying? If you go to school and graduate college, you must give it 100%. If it's you working a 9-to-5, a good job, you must give it 100%. If you play basketball, whatever it is, tennis, any sport, anything, you gotta give it 100%. And that's what you do. Here. This sport can kill you. One punch. It can change your life forever. It has been going on the same way for years. So, you know, you gotta sacrifice the things that you want to do for the things that you need to do. So, training full time, staying focused. You know, partying in the club and stuff like that. Yeah, we all want to have those big, yeah. But at the end of the day, I want to be a little bit. You know what I'm saying? know what I'm saying? That's bigger than going to the club. When I become a world champion, the club will still be there. The people in the club will still be there. You get what I'm saying? So it's about, you know, every day you want to get closer and closer to your goal and dream. You know what I mean? And it is, I'm blessed with the talent to play. You know what I mean? And it can take me to different levels in life. So here it is. That's why I give everything I have for the sport.
About the club and
everything. Yeah.
So, what do you think?
My mom wasn't always working about me, but now she's my number one. She's my number one supporter. She's my number one supporter. You know, always there, always pushing me. My mom, she's gonna be there screaming louder than anybody in the arena or whatever it is. So that's the person I do this for, my mother.
When
we scheduled to fight Julio Cesar Chavez August 27th, we don't know if it's gonna happen. We're still waiting. On our end, we're good. When they're in, it's kind of a question mark. That comes with the game. So right now we're just gonna continue. Like I said, it is a lifestyle. Even though I don't fight, I continue to train. I stay ready so I don't have to get it.
So you're saying the punches, you take the wrong punch, you could die. What do you think your life is after punch?
Well, that's how you train. See, I've trained to take the left punch. I don't want nobody punching on me. You don't want nobody punching on you. You don't want nobody punching on me. So in this game, you can hit. It's kind of hard. Floyd Mayweather beats you. You know what I'm saying? It's about, you know, decreasing the punishment, decreasing the time that you can be. Defense. And that's what you work on. Defense. A good defense is a good offense. You know what I'm saying? Your offense is a good defense. You know what I'm saying? So, I don't want to bite this up. So that's what we work on. Moving our heads. Yeah. Making yourself less and better.
I'm Isaac Cherry, and we're with Jelion Love and King Davis of Sports Talk and Entertainment with Isaac K. Cruz in Las Vegas at the Mayweather Boxing Club, and we're signing out.